daughter's team.
I am. They're doing well, though. I mean, they've been playing for like a year and a half.
What's their record?
They don't have seasons. It's crazy. They just have tournaments like every weekend.
Do you think your daughter might want to play in the WNBA?
She does for sure.
She does?
Like, I mean, this kid, man.
Wouldn't that be great?
Dude, man, I'm telling you. The best thing that happens is when we go out and fans will come up to me and she'll be standing next to me and they'll be like, hey, you gotta have a boy. You and V gotta have a boy, man. You got somebody carry on the tradition, the legacy. She's like, oh, yeah. I got this. You know, boy, for that, I got this. Like, that's right. Yes, you do. You got this.
There's Mr. Bryant.
It's his daughter, Gianna, that's sitting beside him.
Kobe and his daughter in the building, breaking down the game.
I love this for multiple reasons. Great to have, of course, Kobe Bryant, his daughter here. But he's been breaking down the whole time to his daughter, who's a basketball player herself.
What?
And that's a beautiful thing to see.
So you're busier than ever. You're retired, but then since you've retired, you've been become a New York Times best-selling writer.
We're at home, you know, dealing with my daughters and watching them play sports. It's important to have. You know, I try to teach them life lessons. And they just kind of look at me like, Dad, shut up. You don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
So I figure I better put it into a sports story that involves a little fantasy and magic.
Right.
This way I can teach them without them having to roll their eyes when I talk to them.
Well, and they should read these books. Do they read your books?
They do. So they read them as I write them.
Oh, that's great.
So we'll be sitting there and I'll bring back a chapter or, you know, or a couple ideas and they'll look at me and be like, Dad, that's a really bad idea.
Oh, they give you notes?
Oh, all the time. Or, that's great, Dad. Keep doing that.